Justice Carpio, we spoke to an official of the National Maritime Council yesterday, its spokesperson, Undersecretary Alex Lopez. He tells us that the Philippines wants to be seen as an independent and capable nation. But the reality, the sad reality, is that China is one of the world's largest economies and that it has more resources and ships, and that Manila simply cannot just outlast them in terms of vessels and resources. So if the Philippines, if this current administration continues to insist that it does not want to seek aid from Washington, what else can Manila do to increase its chances of effectively deterring China in the West Philippine Sea?
Well, I've been recommending that the Philippines should file another arbitration case against China for damaging our Coast Guard vessels to recover damages. And the rule is, once the arbitral case is filed, the parties should not aggravate the dispute. Because if the Chinese continue to ram our vessels, that will be disrespect to the tribunal, and the tribunal will be hard on China. That's exactly what happened in the 2013 arbitration. While the arbitration was going on, China built the artificial islands. And so tribunal actually castigated China for aggravating the dispute during the proceedings. So we should use that avenue to deter China. But I think we should reconsider. We should ask allies to help us, because it's so lopsided. China's the largest Coast Guard fleet in the world, the largest Navy fleet in the world. And if we continue this way, we will run out of vessels. They'll all be rammed.
Justice, would it be fair to say that the Philippines this time around should choose practicality over its pride?
Again, please.
Would it be fair to say that this time around, the Philippines should choose practicality over pride?
Well, it's not... we have a mutual defense treaty. It's part of statecraft that it's not a matter of pride. It's a matter of wisdom. I mean, you will be dumb if you continue doing the same thing. You'll run out of Coast Guard vessels. I think it's not even practicalities. It's demanded by necessity. It's part of statecraft. It's very clear under the UN Charter. You are allowed to have a mutual self-defense with other countries against aggression by other states. So it's not a matter of pride. It's allowed, in fact, under international law.
Right. So definitely nothing illegal there, nothing that will betray our constitution in any sense. What do you think, then, is stopping the Philippine government from actually seeking the aid not only of Washington, but even other countries that have been supporting the Philippines in terms of its stand in the South China Sea?
Well, I really cannot understand now, because we're running out of options. If we continue this way, we'll run out of vessels. They will all be rammed. And that's precisely the plan of China. We just have to change our tactics now.
Mm-hmm. Justice Carpio, you mentioned that another arbitration case needs to be filed against China. But the problem with the last one was that China refused to honor or to recognize the jurisdiction of the arbitral court. What can we do about that this time around so that somehow the Philippines can have a more responsive China when it comes to court rulings?
Well, China will not participate again in a second round of arbitration. The award will be against China. But like in the first case, countries of the world will support that award. In the case of the 2016 arbitral award, the U.S. and its allies are sailing in the West Philippine Sea. And when they sail, they tell China, we can do this because of the arbitral award. This is the exclusive economic zone of the Philippines, and there is freedom of navigation and overflight. Even if this is within the 10-dash line, even if you say that we cannot conduct naval drills, we will conduct naval drills because of the arbitral award. So that is, in fact, enforcement of the arbitral award. People don't realize that. Now, if you assume let us say that the U.S. and its allies withdraw from the South China Sea today, tomorrow, the 10-dash line is the national boundary of China. Nobody will oppose China. It's actually the freedom of navigation and overflight operations of our friends, the U.S. and its allies, that is preventing China from enforcing the 10-dash line.
Right.
So there is actual enforcement.
Mm-hmm. Right. So an arbitral award basically creates a legal basis that other countries can use whenever they support the Philippines' stance on this issue. But Justice Carpio, does the Philippines still have enough time to file another arbitration case? We are already nearly the halfway mark of the Marcos Jr. administration, and we are not sure if the next administration, whoever that may be, would be as aggressive when it comes to pushing the Philippines' rights in the West Philippine Sea.
We can file it, and while the case is going on, there is the rule of international law that the parties should not aggravate the dispute. And China will be aggravating the dispute if they continue to ram our vessels. And they will be handed down a hard decision by the tribunal if they do that.
Mm-hmm. Justice Carpio, despite the 2016 arbitral award in favor of the Philippines, which invalidated China's 9-dash line, Beijing seems to not be deterred by that particular award. Talk to us about the reputational cost that China is actually endangering when it comes to violating this kinds of international rulings.
China is saying that they consider the award null and void. They will not honor or respect it, but their guru, Wu Shikun, he is the number one public intellectual of China when it comes to the South China Sea. He has stated publicly, and it's widely quoted, that despite everything, the arbitral award has a negative effect on China that cannot be erased. And he said we should prevent the Philippines from filing another arbitral case because he's afraid if another arbitral award is handed down against China, then that will bury forever the Chinese claim to the South China Sea under the 10-dash line. So it has an effect, but they don't accept it. Of course, they will not publicly accept it, but it is hurting them. It's damaging them.
Mm-hmm. Justice Carpio, the Marcos administration earlier said that it's in the process of a case buildup against China for the filing of a possible second arbitration case. Did they consult you by any means?
Well, I have informal talks, but that is about the damage to the marine environment. That's a separate case. I'm talking about the damage to our vessels when they rammed our vessels, when they punctured our vessels. We can demand damages for that.
Right. And based on these informal talks, what's taking it so long before the Philippines could file either of these cases?
Well, I do not know what's taking them so much time, but the number one requirement, I have told them that we must have a marine scientific survey, an assessment that the damage was man-made and not done by hurricane, by storm or tsunami, because we have to establish that. Unlike the unlike in the 2012 arbitration, in the 2013 arbitration, we have seen China pile up creating pile up sand, creating their artificial islands. But here nobody saw them, and that has to be established by scientific evidence. We have to have a marine scientific survey, and that takes time.
Mm-hmm. Justice Carpio, the Marcos administration, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. in particular, repeatedly mentions that the Philippines will still resort to diplomatic channels, to diplomatic means of resolving tensions in the West Philippine Sea. But we all know what happened in the Ayungan Shoal during the Aquino administration. Would it be wise to still trust China at this point when it comes to actually doing good on their word?
Well, we've never trusted China because they engage always all the time on double talk. But we should continue talking to them, but that is not the only recourse we can do. We can file an arbitration case. That's part of a peaceful settlement of dispute. That's allowed under the UN Charter. So we should use all of these courses of action. We should not be limited to just diplomatic talks.
Finally, Justice Carpio, time is of essence here because while the Philippines dilly-dallies on the filing of arbitration cases against China, Beijing continues to build up its assets in our own exclusive economic zone and in the rest of the South China Sea. Your final thoughts on what the Philippines can do to expedite the filing of these charges and including the buildup of its defense resources to be able to put a better stance or better chance against China?
Yes, we should all use all the possible means of defending our maritime zones, and one of those means is to file an arbitration case, a second arbitration case. We have not done that, and we just keep on talking to China, but China says one thing but does another thing on the ground and in the sea. So we have to do more than just having consultations with China, because China keeps on engaging in double talk. China always says, we will follow international law, we will abide with UNCLOS, but on the ground, they do not. They ram our vessels. It's very clear, they do not follow international law. We have to go to the tribunal already.
Right, and we will just have to wait and see on whether or not this administration would actually heed your nuggets of wisdom and pieces of advice. Thank you so much for joining us this morning, former Supreme Court Justice Antonio Carpio.
Thank you, Katrina.